Now, I'm a rather latecomer to the Final Fantasy series, since my very first Final Fantasy was Final Fantasy X. Yeah, so whenever I talk to Final Fantasy fans on the forums or the like, many of them repeatedly said how Final Fantasy IV and Final Fantasy VI were classic masterpieces that haven't been matched by later 3D Final Fantasies. Upon hearing such things, I decided that I needed to really try those games out, but since I did not own an NES, I sought out the Game Boy Advance port of the game and put it in my DS Lite. Even though I have never played the original version, I kind of have a feeling that this port has some mishaps here and there. I mean, it's a bit laggy at times. But even so, I also feel that this port doesn't stray too far from the original, so perhaps my criticisms as well as praises of this port can be applied to the original game. First off, this game is most famed for its storyline. Imagining myself to be back in 1991, yes, I too agree that Final Fantasy IV's story is quite epic. There are, of course, very cliché events, but I like to think that the reason is because this RPG was the starter of those JRPG plot clichés. Personally, however, I did not find much of the story elements to actually be cliché. The script and the dialogue is extremely well written, supported by interesting original characters and unpredictable plot twist. A Dark Knight is on his journey to redemption, while his former squadron and king are plotting to overtake the world via mystical crystals. The journey involves a once wise sage who's now bent on revenge, a monk that's more preoccupied with ass kicking than with celibacy, a summoner child who agrees to aid the murderer of her parents. This journey will take the game's protagonist to lava-filled underworld, to the moon, and to the heart of evil itself. It's an epic journey that sends important messages about the fragile nature of the human heart. It can be cliché at moments and can certainly be totally nonsensical in some other moments. But for the most part, the lengthy story is Final Fantasy's strongest aspect. And when you find yourself wondering why some characters just don't have any depth at all, I think it's good to remember that this is a 1991 game, and at that time, in terms of story, there really was no equal, no worthy rival. On the gameplay front, Final Fantasy IV Advance is sort of a mixed bag. Maybe the negative issues I faced with the game only pertains to the Game Boy Advance port, but whatever the case may be, while I was entertained by the game's simple active time battle system, I was also majorly annoyed by the game's numerous design flaws. To you Final Fantasy fans out there, I may sound like I'm excessively nitpicking, and I usually do nitpick a lot, so perhaps I am, but I personally believe that the best review is an honest one. And if I don't talk about the things I didn't like about Final Fantasy IV, I definitely would end up being dishonest in this video. The first thing that I'm going to nitpick about are the playable characters. Unlike some Final Fantasy games like Final Fantasy III and Final Fantasy Tactics, you cannot choose custom jobs for your characters. Each character has his or her job, her preset job. This is all fine, I don't mind that at all. Except for the fact that at times, some characters are absolutely worthless in battle, especially characters that aren't physically strong. Edward the Prince, for example, was so weak and left my party so quickly that I just couldn't believe that such a character was even introduced in the game. More than that, characters that are only useful when using MP becomes less effective due to the fact that MP increasing items like ether or something like that can't be bought at stores, but can only be found in the battlefield. So they're really precious items, those MP increasing items. It doesn't help that some moves use so much MP. Thus, the safest and really the only gameplay tactic to use in this game is to attack with physically strong characters and then occasionally heal with supporting characters, saving up MP for either those enemies that are invulnerable to physical attacks or for bosses. It's a tactic easy to become accustomed to, but it's a rather annoying one at that. Moreover, this tactic becomes even more annoying when it's that moment to grind and level up your characters to progress the story. My next topic of nitpicking is the inventory system. It's capped, and you can only carry a certain amount of items. When you obtain more than 99 of the same item, it counts as two or more kind of items held. I understand the original Final Fantasy IV had this flaw because of the limited storage space of the NES cartridge, but as a 2005 Game Boy Advance port, it's rather annoying to be hindered by this outdated design flaw. There are, of course, fat chocobos which act as item banks, but there are very few existing in the game, and having to go back to these chocobos to access the items that you formerly banked really doesn't fix the issue. My last area of nitpicking pertains to the active time battle system itself. It can be very inaccurate at times. I don't know if this is the fault of the GBA port or of the Final Fantasy IV itself, but regardless, this flaw exists, where turns are often unpredictable when the ATB meter for that character end at similar times. I admit this is really just nitpicking, but it often negatively affected the strategizing aspect of the gameplay. Now, I realize my nitpicking here is very personalized and obviously being biased, but I felt they needed to be mentioned. What matters in the end is that Final Fantasy IV is a classic JRPG, which set the bounds for an epic storytelling for future game. And while gameplay mechanics may have certain flaws, it's still great entertainment to those remotely interested in any kind of role-playing game.